Hong Kong is set to go ahead with a very controversial bill regarding their extradition request. So today we at Indian Folk will try to analyze what does this bill entail, what are the criticism against this bill, and how has the government responded to such criticism. Several commercial offences such as tax evasion have been removed from the list of extraditable offences amid the concerns from the business community. Hong Kong officials have said that Hong Kong courts will have the final say whether to grant such extradition requests, and suspects accused of political and religious crimes will not be extradited. The government has sought to reassure the public with some concessions, including promising to only hand over fugitives for offences carrying maximum sentences of at least 7 years. Now the question comes, why are people protesting against this law? Hundreds of thousands of people, organizers say even 1 million of them, have taken to the streets of Hong Kong in a vast protest against this proposed extradition law, as they believe that this will allow mainland China to pursue its political opponents in the city, which has traditionally been a safe haven from the Communist Party. There has been a lot of public opposition, and critics say that people would be subjected to arbitrary detentions, unfair trial and torture under China's judicial system. The bill creates a system for case-by-case fugitive transfers between the semi-autonomous Hong Kong and regions with which it does not already have agreements, including mainland China. Critics say that the proposed law would legitimize abduction in the city and subject political opponents and activists to China's widely criticized judicial system. They fear a pro-Beijing Hong Kong government would not resist requests of a political nature. Now the question comes, why is the Chinese judicial system criticized? There is a deep distrust of China's poor human rights record and its opaque legal system with no guarantee of a fair trial, arbitrary detentions, forced confessions, political prosecutions, and the use of torture and other cruel treatments. For years, China has operated as a global kidnapping campaign to forcibly bring both Chinese citizens and foreign nationals back to China to face justice. Victims of these abductions include Gui Minhai, a Hong Kong-based bookseller who was snatched from Thailand and later immersed in detention in China. Lawyers in Hong Kong have pointed out that the proposed law has insufficient built-in safeguards for fair trials and right protection. For example, while the ordinance says that the suspects shouldn't be extradited for offences of a political nature, the onus is placed on the suspect to prove that the extradition request is politically motivated. While Hong Kong's well-respected courts are involved in the process, the courts are not empowered to examine whether the suspect would receive the basic human rights protection upon removal, according to a Hong Kong Bar Association. Instead, the courts have narrow review powers and can only look at whether there is sufficient prima facie evidence to convict the suspect. Critics also worry that the chief executive who make the final decision on the extradition request will be swayed by the Beijing's influence, given that the position is effectively Beijing appointed. So how has the government responded to such wide-scale criticism? The government says that it has sought to address some of these criticism, even as it has ignored demands to scrap or at least delay the bill. In addition to removal of some of the commercial crimes and raising the minimum threshold of extraditable crimes to those punishable by 7 years in jail, Chief Executive Carrie Lam announced yesterday that additional safeguards such as a time limit to request an extradition after an offence and the request must come from the highest authorities would be legally binding. In response to the concerns about the possible chilling impact on the freedom of speech, Hong Kong has said that the law is only meant to deal with the gravest of crimes and will only impinge on the freedom of speech of the press and of publication. With this, we come to an end of our video. Thank you for watching our video. Stay tuned at Indian Folk for more such videos.